Welcome all of you on behalf of Prana. This all started as a personal journey actually for some people. So to name mainly to myself and Mr. Rajiv Bajaj. Am I heard clear?
You can hear me later.
So our journey is, I mean, one was in the business world and one was in the homeopathic world. And as we were trying to meet the challenges of our enterprises at different parts of the country and the world, even before we met each other, our interest and curiosity, me because I'm a homeopath, he because he's a successful businessman and was looking at alternative options to enhance his practices, our journey took us towards deeper understanding of in-depth homeopathy. And this brought the two of us together, and he was probably one of the most challenging and yet stimulating patients who eventually became a friend and now even a big supporter, which I am grateful for, posed certain questions to me, which I hope one day will come up in the form of a book, because we would just sit and he would question, and if my family knew that Rajiv Bajaj had the last appointment of the evening, they knew that I'm not going to come home in time for dinner. So हम बैठते थे, वो सवाल पूछते थे, मैं जवाब देता था, but it made me go deeper to understand the intricacies of our wonderful science homeopathy. While that was going on and he started referring cases, his own health and family started prospering health-wise, the bonding increased. And we felt in what other ways we can extend this service, not just to us, but to even others. The seeds of it probably had been sown in my little clinic at Manavri, where we would just sit and chat. While that was happening, another interesting development took place for both of us. Besides our exercise routine and regime, both of us felt the need to inculcate yoga as part of our discipline. And interestingly so, of course, one associates Pune with Ayurveda yoga, but there are other styles of yoga. But he started off with his own teacher, I started off with my own teacher. And one day he asked me another question. He said, Doc, aapne apni homeopathic dawa, for those of you who are not familiar, you know, constitutional dawa homeopathy mein hota hai, एक्यूट दवाइयाँ भी होती हैं, एपिडेमिक के लिए भी दवाइयाँ होती है, बट कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल दवा सबका एक होता है विच दे नीड प्रॉबली नीड फ्रॉम देयर बर्थ एंड टू द टाइम दे डाई. वी ऑल हैव आवर कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल विच सम होम्योपैथ्स लाइक टू टर्म इन इन्वर्टेड कॉमास आर लाइफ रेमेडी. सो ही सर, आपका लाइफ रेमेडी आपने लास्ट कब लिया है? सो आई सेड, इंटरेस्टिंग क्वेश्चन, बट वाकई मैंने काफी दिनों से लिया नहीं. इसे मैंने भी नहीं लिया. सो क्या, व्हाट इज द, पहले हमको लगता और अब हम नहीं ले रहे, तो व्हाट इज इन आवर लाइफ दैट इज गोइंग ऑन के दवा रिपीट करने की जरूरत, आवश्यकता नहीं हो रही. एंड देन दैट इज नॉट, वी सेड द कॉमन डिनोमिनेटर इन दैट वॉज द अयंगर योगा. सो वी वर डूइंग योगा एंड we were convinced that it was the yoga that was keeping our breath in harmony, our immunities intact, and even though we were faced with various challenges separately, he in his workplace, I in my workplace, and in my personal life, we were yet able to withstand the pressures without having to need our remedy or any other remedy. I haven't had an allopathic remedy now for years. I don't remember, maybe a paracetamol years ago as a child, maybe, because my father is a pediatrician. Us samay shayad liya hoga, but he is also a very different kind of a doctor, my father. The background mein isliye bata raha hu ke even the seeds of holistic health, even though homeopathy was, I was not even a homeopathic student there, but ek shuruaat wahan se hi hua ke health is not just about taking medicines. Health is about understanding कि बीमारी हुई क्यों और अब हम क्या कर सकते हैं in trying to improve our lifestyle in order to see that stressful situations don't overcome us. So that was one part of my training. The other part was, my father was a very busy man and he was attached to various institutes. But one thing that he would do, and he would enjoy doing, even he doesn't, he does them even now, is going into the villages, into the rurals, and doing social service. And at that point, just as kids, it was just the countryside, but in order to spend more time with him, because if he was away on Sundays, that meant that even on Sundays we wouldn't have time to be with him. We would just accompany him, more out of fun. But that fun turned into, even before I knew I want to enter the medical system, into a feeling of that health is something which should be available to everybody. Nobody has a privilege towards good health. It is the right of everybody from the lowest of strata to the highest. It is unfortunate sometimes that that is not the case. At Prana, at first sight, when you see it superficially, some of you may not have questioned or maybe will not even question. I hope you question. But you have a look at it and you say, isn't it too posh or sophisticated to offer quality service to when people of all strata feel comfortable coming here? Or is it just for the privileged and the rich? Me, my wife and our team, she's a designer, have taken great pains to see that even though it is designed in a very modern way, the idea of Prana is to encourage people of all types of life to come here, feel comfortable coming here and to avail of treatment in this center. And that's exactly, we have just started, we are very new, we need your support to reach this out to people that this is what the scheme is doing here. But already I have seen in that child corner, which is a beautiful place, you must have seen it as soon as you entered. The center is still not ready, some things still have to come up. I've seen small children from different religions interacting with other children from wealthy classes, and they are playing as if they don't know and they don't care where they have come from. They are just there to enjoy the area, and that is the kind of reach and patients who are coming to us. And we make sure that even though there is a certain quality in what we offer, those who can afford pay it, those who can't, we are happy to take whatever they can afford if they request so. With this background, I also want to quote Guruji Iyengar, which is, he means it for yoga, but in a way I know what he means is health, and yoga is proper alignment. Ye cheez ko samjhiye zara, just absorb it. When we are not in alignment, when the mind and body is not in alignment, we are susceptible to external forces, which make us in turn susceptible to all kinds of diseases depending on our genetic predispositions which we are born with, which we have no control over. But at that point, what you need to remember is that we think it is the virus, it is the bacteria, and there's a school of thought which says recognize the virus, attack the virus, and make sure that if the virus is killed, the disease is killed. But that is where Dr. James Tyler Kent, a homeopath who's no more, I'm talking of years ago, said maybe the virus also has a cause. Isko thoda sa samjhi. It is the virus that comes up as a manifestation, but what is it in our soils which makes us susceptible for that virus to grow in the first place, is what needs to be understood and what needs to be addressed. It was this journey which, after being in the rurals and seeing all kinds of epidemics, malnutritions of such deep gravity, which pained me a lot to see how, I mean, in a play, you know, we are talking India is shining, but on the other hand, you are seeing Beriberi and you are seeing Kwashiorkor, and it saddened me to a large extent. Then, of course, I got busy with my medical journey. Towards the end, I realized that my journey will not be complete without understanding what are the challenges of the West. So it made me actually go to Vancouver and spend some time there. And then I realized that the challenges may be different, but they were as tragic, they were as traumatic. Autism was coming in such a big way. Learning disabilities was being hit in such a way. Divorce rates were so high. Sexually transmitted diseases were so high. And I, you know, it left me with a feeling that there is materialism, but inside somewhere, the soul is either empty or it has lost its journey in its path. I came back to India, and that is when this opportunity arose. Now, what we felt was that though in homeopathy the concept is of individualization, bimariyan aap samjho aap 10 logon ko diabetes hai, but har 10 logon ko alag dawa diya jayega. Now, this is a strange concept because in allopathy, sabko ek standard dawa or at the most insulin to go with it diya jata hai. But in homeopathy, bimari ek, dawaiyan seven. Which brings us to the concept of individualization. What is the individual custom fit need for every patient? So on one hand, we said we will do this and we will try to create multi-speciality clinics. And this is all part of our team who have their own skills and multi-specialities ranging from pediatrics to allergies to orthopedics to sport injuries to gynec, counseling, cancer. While this was going on, as Amrut rightly said, the challenges of an epidemic and seeing what had happened with swine flu, it hit us. I was traveling and as soon as I came back, it was on the decline and the question was, what are we doing about dengue? There were so many patients, they were suffering, people were dying, especially those with lower immunity. And we felt that we were responsible in some way to offer some solution. That is when this journey, what I want to talk to you about today, really began. But this is the background.